And right now I can see that from the 76 form completions that Meta attributed to our campaign, actually 26 of those were generated by a last click Google visit. Hi there. Today I will show you a quick tutorial on how you can create a conversion, a lead form, a purchase, any type of conversion on a last click Google attribution, and then send it to Meta Events Manager and add it as a custom column in the Meta Ads reporting interface. So let me quickly show you what I mean by a last click attribution coming from Google. Let's say I'm searching for my website, but I'm social in Google and I click to visit my website. The referrer will now be google.com. However, when I click through another page, the last referrer would be my own domain name. So it overrides google.com and it would now be bramsocial.com. If I would now submit a form on this page, the last referrer would be bramsocial. But actually, that should be google.com. So to make sure we are sending the last click Google, we need to create a little script in Google Tag Manager to add the last referrer to the session storage of my website. And then we can leverage the last referrer in a trigger to send a custom conversion to Meta Ads reporting. So let's get started and navigate to Google Tag Manager now. So I'm here in my Google Tag Manager account, and the first thing we'll need to add is a JavaScript custom HTML tag that will set the original referrer in the session storage. And let me quickly show you the session storage on my website. So when you right-click on the Inspect tool and you navigate to the application, you will see the session storage right here. If you open it, you can click on your domain name. And here we need to add the original referrer. So the tag that we will be creating right now will do just that. So navigate back to Google Tag Manager, click to create a new tag. Select the custom HTML tag and copy paste the script. And I will link to the script in the video. This is the script. And what it does is it will set an original referrer in the session storage. So it will first look if there is already a referrer stored. If not, it would get the referrer from the document referrer. So we want to enable this one and store it in the session storage for every page view. So the trigger would be all pages. So let's create a trigger just for this. Let's call it all pages store session referrer. So it will keep the referrer during the session. If they navigate to another subdomain or another domain, or they close the tab and come back, it will be gone, of course, because it needs to keep the same in the same session. Therefore, it would be a last click attribution model. So just select all pages, hit save, and let's call this tag store session referrer. Also make sure to always ask for consent. So right here, we want the script to load on every page. We also want to load it once per page, and the consent settings, because we are using it for reporting and ads, we will select the ad storage and also the analytics storage. Be sure to have implementation ready, like CookieBot or UserCentrics, so you can ask for cookie consent before firing these kind of tags. Now let's preview and see if it really adds the referrer. Let me quickly close this one and preview our changes. Okay, so right click and hit Inspect tool. Navigate to the application session storage, my domain name, and right here you can see the original referrer is tagassistant.google.com. So that's correct because I'm previewing from the tagassistant.google.com. I will publish my changes. In the next step, we will go to Google and I will check if the original referrer Google will keep when browsing multiple pages on my website. So right here, I'm in Google. I've searched for my website Bram Social. So I click to visit my website. Now, when I go to the inspect tool and look for the application session storage from my website, I can see that it added original referrer Google. Let me quickly change my screen because you're unable to see it. So right here, you can see it's google.com. Now, when I click to another page, it will keep google.com. So this script will make sure it will keep google.com throughout a full session. So right now, what we need to do is create a trigger that will filter by original referrer contains www.google, and then use that trigger to fire a custom conversion so we can measure and compare the conversions being measured by and reported by Meta Ads. Let's say that Meta Ads reported one conversion on a one-day click attribution, but actually that one happened after a click on a Meta Ad, and then the person went to Google, clicked on Google organic or paid result and then converted. Actually, that would be a last Google click conversion. And this way, once we add this to the Meta Ads reporting, we can see that that one-day click conversion actually came from Google. The next step is to create a trigger that we will use to create a custom conversion in Meta Ads reporting. Right here, I'm back in Google Tag Manager, and I will need to create a trigger that fires only form completion when the original referrer was Google. But we first need to create a variable for this so we can use it as a secondary condition on the confirmation page. So navigate to the variables. And right here, we need to create a new variable. Click to select a custom JavaScript and paste the code. I will also add this code to the description of the video. It will return the session storage, so the original referrer. And let's call this variable original referrer session storage. Like this, hit save. Okay, now navigate back to the triggers part. Select a trigger. For me, I will, in this example, I will be using a form submission, but it can be any trigger, for instance, a purchase or another e-com event like add to cart. Open it. In this case, I'm setting a trigger on my thank you page whenever someone submitted my form. But now I want to use this trigger only when the original referrer was Google. So I will add another condition and select the variable I just created. Original reference session storage contains www.google. I will call this form completion via Google last click. Hit save. Okay, so now in the next step, we will navigate back to my website. I will come from the Google search engine, open my website, navigate to the page where I can submit the form, and I will land on the thank you form. And in that case, it would need to fire my tag that only fires upon the form completion coming from last click Google. First, create a tag in Google Tag Manager that will create a custom conversion that we can send to the Meta Events Manager and data reporting tools. So click to create a new tag. Here, once again, select the custom HTML. And right now we are going to create a custom event that we will send to Meta Events Manager. So right here, I'm using Track Custom. If you're using a template, that's fine too. Just make sure to select a custom event and not a standard event, because then you're duplicating and you'll be counting events multiple times. So you don't want it. This is just for reporting purposes. That's why I'm creating a custom event. You can call it whatever you want. Let's call this one form completion via Google. And I only want to fire this once per page. Again, require additional consent for tech to fire. I'm selecting the ad storage, also the analytics storage. And for the triggering part, I will link the trigger that we created for the form completion via Google last click. Let's call this tag form completion via Google. And hit save. Okay, so right now, in the next step, we will be debugging this one. I will open the Events Manager on Meta and also the debug window in Google Tag Manager to see if it really fires the tag we just created. Okay, so don't forget to submit your changes. And in the next step, I will open Events Manager so we can debug our configuration to make sure it works. I'm back in Google. I've searched for my website. I'm clicking to open my website. I will navigate to the inspect tool. Just make sure the original referrer is Google. Great. Now I will visit my about page. And as you can see, the original referrer keeps saying Google, so that's perfect. Right here, there's a link I've added to contact me. Here's the lead form. Now I will fill out the form. Submit the form. So it redirected to the confirmation page. The original referrer is still Google. When I navigate back to the Test Events Manager, I can see that the form completion via Google custom event has been fired on the confirmation page. That's great, because that means it works. Now we can use this custom event to create a custom conversion in the Meta Events Manager, so we can add this to our Meta Ads reporting. In the custom conversions interface, click to create a custom conversion. Let's call this one form completion via Google. And right here, the action source is website and the events. You need to select the form completion via Google custom event. Now, it may take some time before this appears. So after implementing this custom event in Google Tag Manager, allow some minutes or even hours, then come back, and then you will need to find this one. So make sure to check it. Then you'll have to set a rule. The rule doesn't matter, so I'm just adding a slash. So this would basically mean each time the form completion via Google event is being fired. Hit to create the custom conversion so we can add it in the next step to our ads reporting interface. Now here in Ads Manager, I've added our custom conversion form completions via Google to the ads reporting interface. And right now I can see that from the 76 form completions that Meta attributed to our campaign, actually 26 of those were generated by a last click Google visit. You now have the insights to know the percentage of completions that actually came from Google. So those 26 form completions, when you're looking at analytics tools like Google Analytics, for example, they tend to report more Google conversions. So these 26 conversions will probably be attributed to Google if you when you look at the Google Analytics reporting. And Meta says that these 26 form completions are actually attributed to Meta, so they are part of the 76 form completions. Now you can use this kind of reporting insights to inform your clients and actually make them see that when you combine multiple channels, advertising channels, they support each other. You can also explain why there are so many differences between the results that Meta reports versus the results that Analytics or Google Ads is reporting. So yeah, good stuff to check. I would say start implementing this right now. And if you have any questions about it, make sure to send me a DM or place a comment and I will make sure to respond to you. So good luck, guys. Happy insights. And don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel and on LinkedIn. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.